I know for teachers, especially if you've been teaching for a while, it's just like noisy or not. You need to calm down. You will eventually, once you start doing these kind of things, you're going to start loving it. And just instead of focusing on how noisy and loud the kids are, focus on how much fun they're having. Okay? This is one of those stories that kids have. By the way, who said they've been teaching here? Like your class? Perfect. Have you guys noticed that every year you guys get one of those kids that kids are loud, they don't listen, and they never miss school? Never. They're always in school. They're always there. You know, and the good kids, the ones that are always listening, the ones, they're missing, they're asleep, they're always missing. Why do you think those kids that do not listen are always in school? Look at it and analyze it, and you know, because your parents rather get rid of them. That's the reason they're in school. Okay? And then one of those perfect days, you know, that child's there exactly on time. And you're like, he's not here today. You have to wait to see the parents. Like, no, we're not here. The day goes by beautiful, no problem. Everything's perfect, right? And then you're like, oh, maybe he's going to take a couple days vacation. The next day, oh, I missed you. I missed you. You need to tell it to the kids. Even if they don't tell them. They'll really be there every day. Oh, I better go to school because she misses. But those kids, you'll never forget. You'll never. Those are the kids I always remember their names. I repeated their names so many times. Stop it. I never forget their names. It's so precious because you, the good kids, you're like, what was it? But the kids that you so much to, you're always like, Bergen, Mike, David. No, you're just like pointing them out everywhere. That's okay. Have the love for it, the passion for it, and don't see up on it. You guys know you guys have to know. Okay, this one goes like this. Five little hot dogs sit frying in a pan. The grease got hot, and one said, BAM! Okay, so, I'm gonna have you here, come on. Hold that for me. And I tell my kids, when you hear the word BAM, we're gonna go, BAM! BAM! And you see you go, BAM! Now the higher you go, the higher it jumps. So you guys might wanna do the BAM pretty good. Ready? Four little hot dogs frying in a pan. The grease got hot, and one said, BAM! That's right, BAM! Three little hot dogs frying in a pan. The grease got hot, and one said, BAM! Two little frying in a pan. The grease got hot, and one said, BAM! One little hot dog frying all alone. The grease got hot, and BAM! He's gone! And the kids like that. Now, if they're going to try to be grabbing hot dogs the first time, just let them be, because they're hot. Right now. The kids will respect that. Just that they're hot, so don't touch around. At the end, they can help you pick them up. But that's the best way to tell them so they don't start grabbing them as they're flying away. Otherwise, you can have five kids come up and they have the hot dogs instead of using the flat board. Okay? Thank you very much.